It's good to see you again, Commissioner. I want to read a quote to you from June of 2014. I want you to tell me if you know who said it, okay? "We confirmed the backup tapes from 2011 no longer existed because they have been recycled pursuant to the IRS normal policy." Do you know who said that?
Sounds like me.
It is you. Can you tell us who "we" is in that quote?
The "we" is the IRS. I tend to take responsibility for the agency and talk about it. I was advised when the draft report was submitted to me that people had talked to everyone in the agency to ensure that in the course of our several months of looking for backup tapes.
So "we" is the royal "we," just speaking on behalf of the entire IRS. How about the word "confirmed"? What does the word "confirmed" mean to you? That you confirmed the backup tapes no longer exist.
Confirmed. When I read that, I asked the question and was told... that,
by whom?
I don't remember who. We had four or five people who were working on the report. Was told, and I gather Mr. Kane said in his testimony, that that was accurate as of June 13th.
What does the word "confirmed" mean to you?
Confirmed means that somebody went back and looked and made sure that, in fact, of all any backup tapes that had existed had been recycled.
Are you still confirmed?
At this point, I have no basis for not being confirmed. I do understand the IG advised me that they were looking at tapes. I have not been advised as whether any of those tapes...
Well, confirmed is a pretty strong word, Commissioner. Are you still confirmed that no backup tapes exist?
Well, at this point, I know the IG is looking and he hasn't found anything. So as far as I know...
I'm glad you mentioned the IG, because I find this confounding. I find it vexing. That once the IG is involved, nobody else can do anything. That is not supported by the law. Can there be a criminal investigation while there's an IG investigation?
There can be all sorts of investigations. What I was talking about is the IG.
Right, and there can be a congressional investigation while there's an ongoing IG investigation also, correct?
Of course.
And there can be an IRS investigation. If there were sexual harassment or discrimination in the workplace, are you telling this committee that you would wait until the IG investigated it before you would stop some insidious practice?
We would take whatever action was necessary, but as a...
Precisely. You would not wait until an IG concluded his or her investigation.
Can I answer that question?
Sure.
Our policy, and it's been my understanding when I chaired the Council of Inspectors General across the government, that if the IG starts an investigation, the agency will not themselves run a competing investigation to try to get there first. That basically the IG advises us what the investigations are. When they advise us about those investigations, we allow them to proceed.
Let me give you a possibly an alternative view, Commissioner, which is that people cite ongoing IG investigations when it suits them to not cooperate, and they don't cite ongoing IG investigations when it doesn't suit them.
That's not my policy.
Well, you can certainly understand how a cynic might view it that way, right? Because there's nothing about an ongoing IG investigation that would keep you from doing your job. It's just like there's nothing about an ongoing IG investigation that keeps the Department of Justice from a criminal investigation or a committee of Congress from a congressional investigation. There's nothing talismanic about an IG investigation.
In this particular case, as a general matter, my policy has always been if the IG is doing an investigation wherever I am, we won't interfere with that investigation. We want it to be independent.
Words have consequences, Mr. Koskinen. Nobody is asking you to interfere. You can have a dual investigation without interfering, can't you?
I think it's very difficult.
So you are saying that if there was an allegation of sexual harassment or racial discrimination within the IRS, you would not look into that until the IG had completed his or her investigation. Is that what you're telling me?
I am not telling you that. I'm telling you as a general matter, that's not what the IG would be investigating. As a general matter, those claims would come to personnel. They would be immediately investigated by our legal department.
Well, the IG doesn't have criminal jurisdiction. The IG doesn't have jurisdiction over legislative policy. The IG doesn't have jurisdiction over appropriations. All three of those are very important areas, so those should be ongoing even while an IG is doing his or her investigation, correct?
Actually, the IG does do criminal investigation.
No, sir, they refer to an entity that actually has the power to indict, which does not include the IG.
They actually, my understanding, like our criminal investigation.
You should go back. It might be the same people who gave you the understanding that you were confirmed that the tapes don't exist. So my advice is to be very careful who you take your advice from. And I'm going to say this in conclusion, Mr. Koskin, I really could not believe the colloquy that you had with one of our colleagues about the morale at the IRS. It takes a lot to stun me, but that stunned me. Here's a piece of advice I would give. If the folks like Lois Lerner and others would have spent more time working on the backlog, more time working on their caseload, and less time targeting groups, and less time trying to overturn Supreme Court decisions they didn't agree with, maybe morale would be better, and maybe their backlogs would be lessened.
Would the gentleman yield?
I'd be thrilled to.